Theodosia stood back to let him in. The front room was white-painted and bare of anything but the most basic furniture. After the heat on the beach, it was very cool, insulated by the cottage's thick stone walls. She closed the front door, then raised her hands and pointed to a blue taverna chair with a woven rush seat, indicating that he should wait. She went through another door, into the back. There was an open laptop on the table next to him. Its screen was blank. Truffler touched a key, and the machine came out of sleep mode. He looked at the images displayed, then must have jogged something because a new window opened. He looked at its contents in puzzlement, until the screen once again darkened. This was one of those rare occasions when Truffler Mason wished he knew a bit more about the new technology. Generally, he was quite content with his status as Luddite dinosaur, but from time to time, more than a basic knowledge of computers might have proved useful. The first image he had seen on the cottage laptop had been self-explanatory. The second, to his eyes, had meant nothing. And yet he felt sure it was something very simple, which anyone who had a passing acquaintance with the ways of Windows would have recognised instantly. If only Erin was there with him on Atmos. Truffler thought of Erin a lot. His thoughts were in no way lascivious. Paternal or avuncular were more accurate adjectives. Perhaps for Truffler, Erin Jarvis was the daughter he never had. He didn't dare touch the laptop again, in case he left signs of his curiosity. He looked at his watch, beginning to think he had been waiting long enough, wondering what might be delaying Theodosia when she reappeared. She said, "Mr. Tate," and circled a finger around the area of her temple in the international sign for mental fragility. Truffler nodded and rose to follow her.